there are some new names on nightclubs. One of them is the Earl of Old Town, and a man who spends an awful lot of time there and makes a lot of people happy is with us tonight, John Prine.
Sam Stone came home to his wife and family after serving in the conflict overseas. And the time that he served had shattered all his nerves and left a little shrapnel in his knee. But the morphine eased the pain, and the grass grew around his brain and gave him all the confidence he lacked. With a purple heart and a monkey on his back, there's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have big ears, don't stop to count the yards. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios. Sam Stone's welcome home didn't last too long. He went to work when he'd spent his last dime, and Sammy took to stealing when he got that empty feeling of a $100 habit without overtime. And the gold rolled through his veins like a thousand railroad trains and eased his mind in the hour that he chose. While the kids ran around wearing up people's clothes, there's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have big ears, don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios. Sam Stone was alone when he popped his last balloon, climbing walls while sitting in a chair. Well, he played his last request while the room smelled just like death, with an overdose hovering in the air. But life had lost its fun, and there was nothing to be done but trade his house that he bought on the G.I. Bill. Fall flag draped casket on a local hero's hill. There's a hole in daddy's arm where all the money goes. Jesus Christ died for nothing, I suppose. Little pitchers have big ears, don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long on broken radios. Thank you.
Did you know Sam Stone?
No, it just rhymed with home.
Huh?
It just rhymed with home.
That's it?
Yeah.
Did you know somebody who was a Sam Stone?
Well, it was more or less, I was just kind of disillusioned after I got out of the Army, you know, and that's what it started out to be, and that's the way the song fell together, so.
Where were you in the days we were talking about, Gatorhorn, early 60s?
I was in high school. Same country songs in the closet.
You made a lot of trips. You're from Chicago, from Maywood, right?
Maywood, right.
Proviso East? What's is that?
Proviso East, yeah.
Proviso Middle.
Right.
yet you went back home to Kentucky, and you really weren't influenced a lot by the city folk people. Your influences came out of your home back in Kentucky, right?
Mainly, yeah. I just never got a chance. I never got down to any clubs or anything. I saw Ray Charles twice.
Well, that ought to do it, I think. You were at the gate of Horn, at the Earl of Old Town, rather, I don't know how long ago, and a guy walked in. Right? A lot of people we've been talking about tonight started at the gate, and we mentioned Bill Cosby and people like that. And you were in a similar situation. You were not a world-famous talent. You were sitting at the Earl one night, and Chris Christopherson walked in, and what happened there?
Oh, yeah, Stevie Goodman brought him over, and Steve sings over at the Earl a lot, too, along with Bonnie Kolak and the Holstein brothers. And Stevie had been playing with Christopherson over at Richard Harding's place, Quiet Night, and he brought him over to hear some of my songs over at the Earl. And he was about the only audience. It was pretty late at night. You know, there's a lot of empty chairs around. We were getting ready to close up, but we stayed open an extra hour, you know.
Did he say, "I'll make you a star, kid"?
No, he listened to the songs. That was good enough for me.
Speaking of songs, there's a new album out, and we're going to hear one of them from that album in a little while. Once again, John Prine, and he will be back in a moment.
Is everybody need somebody that they can talk to, someone to open up their ears and let that trouble through. Now you don't have to sympathize, old cow, with everything, but everybody needs somebody that they can talk to. Well, he spoke to me of morality, starvation, pain, and sin. Matter of fact, the whole dang time I only got a few words in. But I won't squawk, let him talk. Hell, it's been a long, long time. And any friend that's been turned down is bound to be a friend of mine. Go, everybody needs somebody that they can talk to, someone to open up thy ears and let that trouble through. Now you don't have to sympathize, old cow, with everything, but everybody needs somebody that they can talk to. Now we sat there for an hour or two just to eatin' that gospel pie. When around the bend come a terrible wind and lightning lit the sky. He said, "So long, son, I gotta run. I appreciate you listening to me." And I believe I heard him sing these words as he skipped out across the sea. Hey, everybody needs somebody that they can talk to, someone to open up their ears and let that trouble through. Now you don't have to sympathize, old cow, with anything, but everybody needs somebody that they can talk to. Everybody needs somebody that they can talk to.
Where was the name of that place we worked in Denver?
Marvelous Marv's.
Wow.
Leopard skin walls. Yeah.
Yeah, they were We got tricked into that, really. Worked out fine, though, because John and I enjoyed each other. I would listen to John, and John would listen to me. Let's just do what we did. Let me do a little number now, and I'll catch you out there, man. All right?
Okay.
Thanks again.
All right.
Okay. There you go.